Hi, I'm Craig Rowland, founder of Sandfly Security. Today I'm going to demonstrate how to use Sandfly's agentless host drift detection feature on a series of Linux boxes to rapidly help incident response teams isolate systems that have been compromised. For today's demonstration, I've spun up 10 identical systems at DigitalOcean, but it could be at any cloud provider you want or even on-prem. On one of those systems, I installed a backdoor that's masquerading. You can see here in this process listing that one of these processes here is actually malicious. It's a backdoor that will allow instant access to the system if hit by the attacker. What we're gonna do is start from the beginning. We have selected one host here, which is going to be our master host. Basically, this is the host that's our gold image, known good. We want every system we investigate to be exactly like this host. This could be a system that's isolated in a lab. It could be a VM that you spun up on site that you know is going to be good, or it could be any other variety of systems that you know is going to be a good system that has not been compromised. We're now going to go ahead and add the systems we want to investigate. There are a variety of ways to do this, but for today, we're just going to paste in some IP addresses. We have an existing credential we're going to use, and we're going to give the hosts a tag called drift for demonstration purposes. And basically what this allows us to do is any host with that tag on it is going to have the drift profile we created off that master host be applied. So you can have drift profiles for your Ubuntu boxes, for your Arch Linux boxes, for your Gentoo systems, your Rocky Linux, for your Synology systems, Ubiquiti routers, other embedded devices. Basically, it doesn't matter. You can have a drift profile for each, and that's what's going to be able to tell you whether or not something has shifted. For today's demonstration, these are all Ubuntu boxes. They're all identical. I've added them onto this system now, and you just see it takes a few seconds. And what that means is that these systems are basically ready to go. They're ready to be scanned. So what am I going to do now? Again, we're just going to jump to our scan. I'm going to hit new manual scan. I'm going to select all the hosts I want checked. We're going to go ahead and we're going to use the recon modules, and we're going to hit finish, and now they're going to be put into our queue. The reconnaissance modules go onto the system. They collect critical information such as processes that are running, users that are there, SSH keys, kernel modules that are present, cron tab entries, systemd timers, a variety of other things. We can even do traditional file integrity monitoring by monitoring certain directories if you want us to. But the main thing here to understand is that we're rapidly assessing those systems, we're collecting that information, we're going to pull it back to the server, and then we're going to compare it against a master image to see if anything shifted. So for an instant response, this gives you the ability to very quickly find out what systems have drifted from a known good state, so you don't waste a bunch of time chasing ghosts. You're going to go right to the systems that have the problem. And we see here that we already have some systems returned. It takes about 30 to 60 seconds to do this type of assessment. And at this point here, all of them are completed. I'm going to hit refresh, and I see down here that there's one host that has an alert status. This host here, we can see it's an Ubuntu box. We see that there are 5 alerts present, so I'm going to click on those. And here, these are all the drifts we saw on that host. These are the things that are different from our known good image. First of all, for our recon process list, we have a process here with a very strange name called T. And when I click on that process here, we see that it's a drift detection alert because it's not part of the profile. Basically, again, we see a process running on the system that's never been seen in the master profile. Here, it's also got this weird command line. It's also got this command called kworkerd. So it looks like it's trying to work as a kernel worker, look like a kernel worker masquerading somehow, but it's clearly not that. The next thing we have here is a port listening. So we also look for processes with ports listening. This is separate from a process that's simply running. What I mean by that is you could have a shell that's allowed to run, but if it's a shell that's listening on a network port, that all of a sudden is suspicious. Again, same deal. This T process was seen. We could see here it's been flagged as process with a listening port. If I go to my raw data here, I scroll down and I can see immediately there's a listening port here. It's listening on port 31337. It's in a listening state and it's ready to take a connection inbound from anyone. The next thing we're going to find here is that someone left an entry in the cron. And here we have a bogus domain, but basically you can see here that we identified the specific cron entry that is unique and we pulled it out for you so you can see immediately what it is. Then what we did here is we saw that there's a new user added. This was the system user was put on this account down here, and we could see that, okay, it's got a password. I can even see remnants that it has an SSH key present. And that's the final thing we actually found here, user authorized key present. So basically what we did is we found an authorized key file name present on this user that was never seen before. This could be a new authorized key file that was dropped on the system to allow login, or it could be an authorized key file that was modified with a new key in order to allow backdoor access. But the end result is all the same. This system has five very serious changes to it. And again, you saw immediately that that drifted from that master host, and you got no real false positives with it, because we know that these processes were supposed to belong there and where they're not supposed to belong there. And you're told immediately what's going on. So for incident response, it's a really, really cool tool. I recommend that you check it out. You come to our website. It can help you get to the core of a problem during a live incident very, very fast. It's completely agentless. We don't rely on hooking into the kernel. So it's also very, very reliable in terms of working across virtually any Linux system, from systems that are a decade old to modern deployments. I'm Craig Rowland. That's a demonstration of our agentless drift detection for incident responders. Thanks again for watching the video, and please check out our website for more information. Goodbye.